Today, I'd like to address some of the key issues in science today and how that could relate to a colonial mindset. If you look up the information, current science beholds or assumes that the scientific revolution occurred about 1543 with Nicholas Copernicus when he published his book challenging the prevailing view of the solar system. This is often seen as the beginning of the scientific revolution. And this period, during this period also, around 1687, Isaac Newton published his groundbreaking work Principia, which laid the foundation for classical mechanics. And then about 125 years ago, we had the quantum revolution and also the theories of relativity. So very recent according to the prevailing scientific view. However, if you actually look up in detail, the history of science, it goes back also to ancient cultures like India, where there were many, many scientific discoveries made. And the Bakshali manuscript, dated 3rd to 4th century CE, contains one of the earliest records of the zero symbol. The concept was crucial for the development of mathematics and astronomy. Atomic theory, the Vaisheshika school of thought founded around the first millennium BCE, developed an atomic theory that proposed that everything is composed of tiny indivisible particles called Anu. While not identical to the modern atomic theory, it foreshadowed the concept of atoms. Calculus, Aryabhatta, a mathematician and astronomer from the 5th century CE, made significant contributions to calculus, including methods for integration and differentiation. Bodhayana, an 8th century BCE mathematician, is credited with providing one of the earliest known proofs of the Pythagorean theorem. Of course, there were ancient Indian physicians that made huge contributions to systems of medicine such as Ayurveda. Today, we can see that Ayurveda and integrative medicine acts through epigenetic modulation, which is basically knowing modes of experience in consciousness. So Ayurveda also uses certain herbal remedies, one very clearly, curcumin, that directly target the epigenome. So also in ancient Indians devised calendars based on their observation of the stars and planets. The Rig Veda, a very old Indian text, shows they divided the year into 360 days, with subdivisions into months. Indian astronomers made significant progress in understanding planetary movements. Aryabhatta, a 5th century astronomer, proposed a heliocentric model, the sun at the center, centuries before Copernicus or Galileo and others. Indian mathematicians developed trigonometry, which proved to be a powerful tool for astronomical calculations. Also, ancient Indians built sophisticated instruments for observing the night sky. The Jantar Mantar Observatory in Jaipur is a famous example, showcasing architectural wonders used for astronomical purposes. The difference between modern science, first of all, it ignores these ancient contributions altogether. When you look up, the scientific revolution, it's all about 500, 600 years ago. And yet what I've mentioned is much more ancient, more than a couple of thousand years ago, more than a couple of thousand, maybe 2,500 years BC. So obviously there's a bias in science, which, by the way, is based on naive realism because it totally ignores consciousness. Ancient Indian science never ignored that. Vedic astrology, also known as Jyotish, which is frowned upon by modern cosmologists, is rooted in the ancient Vedic scriptures of India. And there are some key concepts around it. So Vedic astrology is based on the idea of a connection between the macrocosm, the universe, and the microcosm, the individual. The positions of the stars and planets at your birth are believed to influence your life path. And also, unlike Western astrology, Vedic astrology uses the sidereal zodiac. This system factors in the gradual wobble of the Earth's axis, which creates a slight difference in the zodiac signs compared to the tropical zodiac used in Western and in Western astrology. Also, in Vedic astrology, there's a concept called nakshatras. Vedic astrology places a strong emphasis on lunar mansions, which are called nakshatras, which are specific sectors along the elliptical path of the moon. These nakshatras hold significance in understanding personality, traits, and life events. So, what is the difference between ancient Vedic science, including astrology and astronomy, cosmology, epigenetics? The difference is that Vedic science is based on a consciousness-based approach. You cannot exclude consciousness in any scientific inquiry, and yet modern science, based on naive realism, posits an observer-independent universe, which is impossible to prove. So as we move into the future, I think we will need to revise our current models of scientific inquiry to include consciousness, which was suggested right from ancient times. I know modern astronomy, based on naive realism, ridicules astrology, ridicules even Ayurveda, which all are based on modes of knowing and experience in consciousness, and do not subscribe to the naive realism of modern scientists. I think it is time to recognize Vedic science and see how it is actually superior to modern science. Let me know what you think and whether we should explore this topic more. Let me know. Okay.